Yeah, so in this video, we are going to talk about permutation importance. And in particular, permutation importance is part of these wrapper methods for feature selection that we started discussing in the last video. So wrapper methods are, again, methods that involve a model for doing the feature selection or the feature importance estimation. And previously, we have seen recursive feature elimination as one example of these wrapper methods. This lecture, we will take a look at permutation importance. And then in the next upcoming videos, we will also talk about another method called sequential feature selection. Yeah, before I give you the nitty-gritty details of how permutation importance works, I thought it might make sense to just give you a two-step outline here to really show you how beautifully simple this method is. So how it works in a nutshell is that for each feature column in a dataset, what we do is we shuffle that feature column, and then what we do is we take an existing trained model and observe the performance of that model on the shuffled dataset, or the dataset with a shuffled feature column, and compare it to the original performance of the model. And then there's usually a drop in performance if we shuffle the feature column, and this drop of performance gives us an indicator of how important that feature is that we have shuffled. It might sound a little bit complicated if I just summarize it in two steps here, so I will walk through this more slowly in the upcoming slides, so don't worry. But really, the nutshell explanation here is that we shuffle one feature at a time, and then we look at the performance of a model before and after shuffling to assess how important that feature is. Yeah, and then when we apply this method to each column in the dataset, we can make such a nice bar plot here and show the importance of each feature, and then also optionally with a standard deviation. And I will also show you how we can make such a plot in the upcoming video, where I go more into the code example. So I will give you the more detailed explanation of permutation importance and the algorithm in a few moments. But before doing so, I wanted to go over noteworthy facts about permutation importance. So permutation importance often gives us similar results as random forest importance based on the impurity that we discussed before. But the nice thing about permutation importance is that it is model agnostic, which means it's not restricted to random forests, but we can use it with any type of machine learning algorithm or machine learning model. So yeah, I have to admit that permutation importance is not strictly feature selection, but it tells us which feature a model relies on the most. So in that sense, feature importance is not feature selection, but we can use feature importance measures to select features actually. So it's kind of a very related topic, which is why I am covering it here in the feature selection lecture. Yeah, and if you recall the previous video where I discussed random forest feature importance, you can think actually of permutation importance as a generalization of method B in the random forest video, but here we are using the holdout set instead of the out-of-bag samples. So if you don't recall what that means, don't worry so much about it, but if you're interested, you can go back to the previous video and check out the explanation of the out-of-bag examples. So here, let me now walk you through the permutation importance algorithm in more detail, step by step. So the first step is that we take a model that was fit to the training set. So for that, we can take any machine learning model or algorithm. And here's just an example. So consider we are using a random forest classifier, and then we fit the random forest to the training set here. So this is how we start. We just train a model on the data set. Nothing really special about this step. Then what we do is we estimate the predictive performance of the model on an independent data set. For example, the validation data set. It could also be the test set. And then we record it as the baseline performance. So here's an example where I'm doing this. So I'm using my fitted random forest, and then I'm computing here the accuracy on a validation set here. And let's say we get 99% accuracy as the validation set performance, and I'm recording this as my baseline performance. So then for each feature J in the dataset, what we do is we randomly permute the feature column in the original dataset. So here on the right-hand side, I have an example dataset. Let's call that X. So X are the features and Y are the corresponding class labels, just like always. And the rows are the training examples and the columns are the features. So here I have three feature columns, 1, 2, and 3, and I have 4 training examples here. Now I have also some example values here just for illustration, just some values we might observe in that feature column. And what we are then doing is we are shuffling that column, and we are here focused on shuffling column 1. Let me use a different color here. And here is the shuffled column 1, and you can see that the order here in that row, in that column, has changed. So we have 1.1, minus 0.1, and so forth. So for example, these are flipped now, and these come first before the 1.4, which is now last. So I'm just randomly shuffling this column. However, note that we are not touching column 2 or column 3, so they stay exactly the same, and also the class labels stay exactly the same, so we are not changing those. So now what we do is we record the predictive performance of the model on the data set with the permuted, like the shuffled column. So permuted and shuffled is here synonymous. And here's an example of how that looks like. So we are again taking the same random forest model here, and now we compute the performance on, let's say, the permuted data set, and we get, let's say, 85% accuracy. And note that before we had 99% accuracy. So lastly, let's go to step C. So step C is computing the feature importance as the difference between the baseline performance from step 2 and the performance on the permuted dataset. So here the baseline performance was 99% accuracy, and the performance of the permuted dataset was 0.85. So the feature importance is the difference between the two, that is 0.99 minus 0.85, which is 0.14. So this is our feature importance of feature 1 here. And of course, I mean, we only considered shuffling this column one time, and there might be something particular about the way we shuffled or the ordering here. So in practice, it's recommended to repeat this a couple of times. So if we have a very small data set, we could repeat this exhaustively, considering all possible ways we can arrange these values in that column. But in practice, it's usually more feasible to do this just a large number of times. So for example, 50 times with different random seeds. Yeah, just shuffling the column 50 times. And then we would compute the feature importance as the average difference. So we would compute this here from 50 times randomly shuffling that column. So each time this value here might be slightly different. So we would then get a slightly different difference, and the average difference would be our feature importance. And we will in the next video see a few code examples on how to do that exactly. So, but let's now assume we get different feature importances for the different columns. So of course we would repeat this procedure for each column in the data set. So let's say we get 0.14 feature importance for column 1, let's say 0.05 for column 2, and maybe 0.21 for column 3. And now thinking again what these numbers represent. So we have a baseline model that gets 99% accuracy, and then the accuracy declines somewhat. And the decline in accuracy, our feature importance, we can think about it as how much the model relies on that feature. Because we are shuffling the order, so we are kind of destroying the relationship between feature value and class label. So in that way, the model might get confused now. So the more the accuracy drops, the more the model was relying on that particular order, on that particular feature. So in that case, we can think of this feature importance as how much the model uses that feature for making predictions. And if we have these three different values, 0.14, let me use a different color, 0.14, 0.05, and 0.21, the larger the drop, the more the model might be relying on that feature. So in this case, 0.21, feature 3, might be the most important feature. And then the second most important feature might be 0.14. So this might be the second most important feature. And then the least important feature would be this one here, because there's only a small difference before and after shuffling that feature. So let me introduce you to one more method here. So this method is closely related to the permutation importance, and it's called the column drop variant, or we can also call it the column drop importance. So how is it different? So instead of shuffling each feature column J, what we do is we temporarily remove that entire column from the dataset, and then we fit a model to this reduced dataset. And then, similar to the permutation importance, what we do is we compute the validation set performance and compare it to before, to the baseline performance. So in a nutshell, the main difference here is that instead of shuffling a feature column, we remove that entire feature column. And because we remove that feature column, we have to refit the model, which can then make this method a little bit more expensive than the permutation importance. Actually, it can be a lot more expensive if we have a model that is very expensive to fit. For example, consider a deep learning model. But as a consequence, it's, I would say, a slightly more accurate method for computing feature importance, because here we really get rid of the entire column instead of just shuffling it. However, because we also have to refit the model, it's not really the importance of that particular model anymore. It's more like the importance of the family of models, or the feature importance for that family of models that we gain from refitting, right? Because originally we have a model fit on the baseline performance and on the baseline data set, or original data set for the baseline performance. And now we have a refitted model, which is a second model or a different model, right? So it's not the same model anymore compared to permutation importance, where we always reuse that same model and we just do predictions on new data sets. But we're not refitting the models in the permutation importance. Anyways, the column drop variant is also a very interesting, very useful variant if you can afford refitting the models. And actually, we will adopt something similar later in a later video when we will talk about sequential feature selection. All right, time to wrap it up. So here on that slide, top of my head, I collected some pros and cons of permutation importance. So one nice thing about permutation importance is that it is model agnostic. So I can use it with any classifier I like. It could be a random forest, a logistic regression model, a deep learning model, whatever you like. And similarly, what's also nice is that it works with any type of metric that we can compute on the validation set or the test set. So previously we looked at the classification accuracy, but we could also look at the F1 score, Matthew's correlation coefficient, R squared, and anything we really like. Also, what's nice is that's easy to understand. So what that means is that, I mean, it's just shuffling the column, right? So we are looking at the performance of the model before and after shuffling a column. So it's not super complicated. If we have collaborators and they ask us, how did you compute this feature importance? Well, we can actually in a few minutes really easily explain how that method works. Another thing is that feature importance is particular to a given model, which is kind of like a pro and a con. So what's nice about it is that it helps us to understand a particular model better. But on the other hand, if that particular model is not very accurate, this estimated feature importance is also not really a good reflection of the performance or the feature importance of that feature in general. And also it doesn't really maybe explain how important that feature is to another model. However, I think I find this more like a pro argument, because it really helps us understand our particular model better. So another pro argument is that unlike impurity-based random forest feature importance, the permutation importance does not suffer from overfitting since an independent dataset is used. So when we compute the random forest feature importance, well, maybe the random forest is overfitting, so how much it relies on a particular feature may not be really a useful measure, whereas here for this permutation importance, we are using an independent dataset, for example, the holdout dataset or the test set, which can be an advantage. However, it can also be a disadvantage if we have a small dataset and we can't afford setting aside for data for validation or testing. So, but in general, I feel this is more like a pro argument. A negative part or aspect of permutation importance is that, like in impurity-based random forest importance, the importance is undervalued if two features are highly correlated. So we discussed this issue before when we talked about random forest-based feature importance based on the impurity. So if we have two features that are highly correlated, they will be sharing the importance. And this can be a disadvantage. So we are maybe underestimating the importance of a feature if there is another feature that is highly correlated to that feature. Why is that? So think about it like that. If the features are equally important, the model may use both features. So in that case, they are sharing the importance. And then also if we remove that feature, it still has the other feature to make the prediction. So in that case, the performance may not really drop so much if it's using the other feature. So, and in the code examples in the next video, I will show you an example how we can, let's say, detect whether we have a problem like that. But since this has already been a very long video, let me wrap this up. And in the next video, we will talk about, I will show you some code examples for computing the permutation importance.